Guys, thank you for tuning into my channel. Today I will be showing you how to make another floral headpiece. A friend of mine just rang me the other day and she asked me if I could make one for her. She's going to an event, a special event, and she'll be wearing she wants to wear a floral headpiece, and she told me that she'll be wearing a red, gold shoes. So I thought, and also she showed me her dress. So that involves, it also is showing the color of the flowers that I've got here. So I'm going to match her dress with this. And when she said that she's gonna be wearing gold shoes, I thought I will use this gold crown as part of the headpiece. So the materials I'm gonna be using is one of these wires. So it'll just go with the gold and the floral. So I'm not sure what flowers I'll be using. So I've got a few collections. So we'll see later what I can do. And of course my weapon, glue gun. And a wire cutter and some leaves. I'll be using that, and also a wire, because I'll be using this wire to go around the head. So stick around and keep watching, and we'll make something nice. Sparkling wire into this gold crown, so it would look like that. So even just that, it's good. It's nice enough just to do that. But I'm going to connect floral flowers around, so I'm not sure how, but we'll see. So the next slot would be this. Measure the size of my head. I think my head is similar size to hers, so I'll just measure my own head. Okay. So that. Maybe a little bit bigger. I'm gonna have an allowance so I can use it to tie it around the crown. So I have to have support. I have to tie this around the crown so it will. Just to secure it. So I'm gonna. Like that. I don't have any plans on how to do it, but I'm just gonna see, okay? See how it goes. Cut enough wire. Tie on the crown. Okay. So that's the crown. So what I'm going to do is to tie it around here. So I got more, it's more secure. So I'm gonna start doing it here. I want to do it when it's not obvious. Like I'm stitching it so it's secure to the crown. No, it's too long. So my friend has asked me if I could make her a fairy godmother, a fairy design headpiece. So this is what I'm trying. I'm gonna try to make one that she likes. Hopefully she likes. So let's keep going. Thank you.
Oops. Be careful when you're holding a glue gun. That's what you get. You burn yourself. I just burned myself. Water is good. Cold water. If you burn yourself, soak your finger. Soak your burned finger in the water. Just a relief from the heat. That's where I am at so far. I have to put some at the top there. So it's taking a while. Thinking, planning, putting together. It doesn't come that easy when you don't have anything to work with. It's all in my head. Be careful holding with glue gun. I just burnt myself. So I soaked my burnt finger in icy cold water. Just a relief. Gives me that relief from the heat. So I'm getting there. I'm just, it's all just slowly come together. I don't have any model or anything to go on. I just do it from my own, thinking as I go. I'll just see if it looks okay or if it doesn't. So that's why it's taking a while. I can't lift my finger out of that without putting it in the water. It hurts when I take it out.
I've done it. So my friend suggested or requested, asking me to make a goddess, like a fairy, godmother headpiece to match with her dress and with a gold shoes. So this is what I've came up. There was no planning, it was just all put together. It took me a while, keep changing and taking off the flowers and put it back in. But I finally did it, so I hope she'd like it. So this is what it looks like at the back. It just needs cleaning from the glue gun. And that's what it looks like at the front. So I've just combined rusty color flowers for piece. And so my friend will be wearing this piece at the Camilla event on the Gold Coast here in Australia at Versace Resort. So it's a Camilla event, so it's a dress-up party and with a beautiful headpiece the ladies will be wearing. And they also have like the best headdress competition. So hopefully, best of luck for you, my friend, Lynn White. So if you win this tomorrow, that would be wonderful. It's worth the job.